Good morning, and welcome to St. James on this beautiful Sunday, the 13th of September. I'm Becky Jones, the rector, and on behalf of all the folks at St. James, I'd like to thank you for joining us for our worship this morning. We're into our second week of celebrating the season of creation, and so today I've come up here to Inspiration Point Park. It's a beautiful spot from which you can see all along the Front Range. It's breathtaking. And a reminder of just how blessed we are and how it truly is a privilege to live in Colorado. Today you may notice a few changes to our service. We're just freshening things up a bit. We'll try singing the Venite today instead of saying it, and we'll be singing the Gloria to a new tune we haven't done before. I hope you like it. This morning, before our service begins, I'm going to invite you to move into an attitude of prayer and enjoy some photos that Susan Clemens has shared with us of her flowers. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. This morning, in celebration of our season of creation, let's join in singing, He's Got the Whole World in His Hands. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Wali. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen.
Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Wally.
This morning, Alfred and the choir are going to teach us a new way to sing the Venite. Let's give it a try.
Oh, come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and show ourselves glad in him with songs. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hands are all the corners of the earth, and the strength of the hills is his also. The sea is his, and he made it, and his hands prepared the dry land. Oh, come, let us worship and fall down, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is the Lord our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Today, if ye will hear his voice, harden not your hearts, as in the provocation, and as in the day of temptation in the wilderness. When your fathers tempted me, proved me, and saw my works. 40 years long was I grieved with this generation, and said, it is a people that do err in their hearts, for they have not known my ways. Unto whom I swear on my wrath, that they should not enter into my rest. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Psalm 103. Please join me in reading the psalm for today, read responsively by half verse. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy, slow to anger and of great kindness. He will not always accuse us, nor will he keep his anger forever. He has not dwelt with us according to our sins, nor rewarded us according to our wickedness. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so is his mercy, great upon those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our sins from us. As a father cares for his children, so does the Lord care for those who fear him. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. A reading from the book of Genesis. Realizing that their father was dead, Joseph's brothers said, "What if Joseph still bears a grudge against us and pays us back in full for all the wrong that we did to him?" So they approached Joseph, saying, "Your father gave this instruction before he died. Say to Joseph, I beg you, Forgive the crime of your brothers and the wrong they did in harming you. Now, therefore, please forgive the crime of the servants of God of your father. Joseph wept when they spoke to him. Then his brothers also wept and fell down before him and said, "We are here as your slaves." But Joseph said to them, "Do not be afraid. I am in the place of God. Even though you intended to do harm to me, God intended it for good, in order to preserve a numerous people, as he is doing today. So have no fear. I myself will provide for you and your little ones." In this way, he reassured them, speaking kindly to them. Here ends the lesson.
Today we're also trying out a new way to sing the Gloria. It's old Rite One language and an old Scottish tune, and I hope you like it.
Glory be to God on high, and on earth his goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us.
Reading from the book of Romans. Welcome those who are weak in faith, but not for the purpose of quarreling over opinions. Some believe in eating anything, while the weak eat only vegetables. Those who eat must not despise those who abstain, and those who abstain must not pass judgment on those who eat, for God has welcomed them. Who are you to pass judgment on servants of another? It is before their own Lord that they stand or fall, and they will be upheld, for the Lord is able to make them stand. Some judge one day to be better than another, while others judge all days to be alike. Let all be fully convinced in their own minds. Those who observe the day observe it in honor of the Lord. Also those who eat, eat in honor of the Lord, since they give thanks to God, while those who abstain, abstain in honor of the Lord and give thanks to God. We do not live to ourselves, and we do not die to ourselves. If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end Christ died and lived again, so that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why do you pass judgment on your brother or sister? Or you, why do you despise your brother or sister? For we will all stand before the judgment seat of God. For it is written, "As I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall give praise to God." So then, each of us will be accountable to God. Here ends the lesson.
Reading from the Gospel of Matthew. Peter came and said to Jesus, "Lord, if another member of the church sins against me, how often should I forgive? As many as 7 times?" Jesus said to him, "Not 7 times, but I tell you, 77 times. For this reason, the kingdom of heaven may be compared to a king who wished to settle accounts with his slaves. When he began the reckoning, one who owed him 10,000 talents was brought to him. And as he could not pay, his lord ordered him to be sold, together with his wife and children, and all his possessions, and payment to be made. So the slave fell on his knees before him, saying, Have patience with me, and I will pay you everything. And out of pity for him, the lord of that slave released him and forgave him the debt. But that same slave, as he went out, came upon one of his fellow slaves who owed him 100 denarii. And seizing him by the throat, he said, Pay what you owe. Then his fellow slave fell down and pleaded with him, Have patience with me, and I will pay you. But he refused. Then he went and threw him into prison until he would pay the debt. When his fellow slaves saw what had happened, they were greatly distressed, and they went and reported to their lord all that had taken place. Then the lord summoned him and said to him, You wicked slave, I forgave you all that debt because you pleaded with me. Should you not have had mercy on your fellow slave as I had mercy on you? And in anger, his lord handed him over to be tortured until he would pay his entire debt. So my heavenly Father will also do to every one of you if you do not forgive your brother or your sister from your heart. Here ends the lesson. Holy Spirit, come, give life to my words. Be in this place. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So, if you were paying attention to our scripture lessons today, you may have noticed a theme: forgiveness. Joseph forgiving his brothers, God forgiving us, us forgiving each other repeatedly, just as God does. It's not necessarily a topic we enjoy talking about much, especially not if we're the person seeking forgiveness, as opposed to the person granting it. We don't like asking for forgiveness. We don't like confessing that we've done something wrong. You know, every Sunday, we begin our service saying the confession. I think most people enjoy that part of the worship just about as much as we enjoy a trip to the dentist to have our teeth cleaned. It's something we know we need to do, but it's nothing we really look forward to. So we say these words that we know by heart, and we go through the proper motions. But I suspect that for many of us, most of the time, it's just a formality. It's just what Episcopalians do. And then comes my part of the ritual, absolving you of your sins, announcing those blessed words of forgiveness, assuring you that your sins have been wiped away by a God whose mercy is everlasting. Do people really believe that? Do you feel forgiven? Does it make a difference in your life? Our psalm today was clearly written by someone who knows very well what it is to be forgiven, who really does believe in a gracious God whose mercy flows over us like a gentle cleansing rain. These are the words of someone whose life has been changed, who has personally experienced the abundance of God's mercy. By God's grace, the psalmist has been lifted up into a whole new world, a world where God's love stretches overhead like the stars in the night sky, and where sin has been removed as far as the east is from the west. This is a God who doesn't deal with us according to our sins. It's a God who has compassion on us, as a parent has compassion on a child. That's what forgiveness can do if we let it. Experience forgiveness can change your life. I think one of my favorite illustrations of this comes from the musical Les Miserables. I'm sure many of you know the story very well. It's about an ex-convict by the name of Jean Valjean. He's just gotten out of prison and he has nowhere to go, so he goes to the home of a local bishop. The bishop welcomes Jean Valjean, gives him food, place to sleep, but in his desperation, Jean Valjean repays the bishop for his kindness by stealing the silverware. The next day, the police catch him and take him back to the bishop. The bishop doesn't respond with anger. Rather than condemnation, he offers only extravagant forgiveness in hopes of saving Jean Valjean's soul. In essence, he tells him to go and sin no more. But rather than me telling you about this, let's watch the scene together, shall we?
Hey! Come and sir, for you are weary. And the night is cold out here. Though our lives are very humble, what we have to share. There is wine here to revive you. There is bread to make you strong. There's a bed to rest till morning. Rest from pain and rest from wrong.
Bless the food we eat today. Bless our dear sister and our honored guest.
Monseigneur, we have your silver. We caught this man red-handed.
He had the nerve to say you gave him this.
That is right. But my friend, you left so early. Surely something slipped your mind.
You forgot.
I gave these also. Would you leave the best behind? Monsieur, release him. This man has spoken true. I commend you for your duty. Now God's blessing go with you. But remember this, my brother. See in this some higher plan. You must use this precious silver to become an honest man. By the witness of the martyrs, by the passion and the blood, God has raised you out of darkness. I have saved your soul for
you know, that scene almost always makes me cry. Jean Valjean was like many of us. He was defined by his past, and he was filled with guilt and regret. Rightly or wrongly, he'd been branded a thief. So he began to behave like a thief. That became his identity. But the bishop tells him that he's been ransomed from that fear and hatred. Forgiveness has set him free from his past, so he could live the life that God intended him to live. And that's exactly what Jean Valjean did in the story. He moved to a new town. He became an upright citizen. He became a blessing to those around him. He helped other people. He fought injustice. He forgave his enemy. He lived the new life that the bishop called on him to live. That is the power of forgiveness. That's the kind of God that our psalmist speaks of, a God of steadfast love and mercy, a God who values relationship over retribution, a God who loves us so much, even when we are at our least lovable. God keeps on reaching out to us, keeps telling us to take the candlesticks too. This God is always willing to let bygones be bygones. I suspect if we were to experience that kind of grace for ourselves, we couldn't help but be transformed by it. There'd be no more mumbling of the words of confession, no more fidgeting during the absolution. Maybe we would come to see our lives in a new way. Maybe we would begin to see and live our lives in such a way that our whole life would become a song of praise and thanksgiving. Our Lord tells us we're to forgive others, just like Joseph forgave his brothers. We're to forgive not once, not seven times, but 77 times, and even more if need be. And you know what? I think some of us can actually do that. I know your willingness to forgive, to overlook the past, to see only the best in others. By and large, you are loving, gracious, merciful people. I think for many folks, there is just one person that we're unable to forgive, one person whose sins are just too great to overlook. And that one person is ourselves. We tend to hold on to those old mistakes, letting them define us, giving them far more power than they ought to have. God said, our sins are as far from us as the east is from the west. They're erased from our history as far as God is concerned. We're the ones who keep bringing them back up. Shame tries to shackle us to our past, to who we were, to prevent us from becoming who we are, who we can be. Don't waste your energy continually dredging up things God has said that you can forget. You lost some time when you made the mistakes. Don't lose any more now, dwelling on them. So, my question to you today is, what do you need to let go of? What past mistake are you still allowing yourself to hold on to? Let it go. And in letting go of your own sins, you can also be free to help others let go of theirs. Amen. And now, returning to our worship, let's say together the words of our faith as found in the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Wali. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Please greet one another with a sign of God's peace.
Peace be with you.
Stay home and warm.
I'm going to put this down so you can hear what I'm saying whenever you're ready.
You go right ahead.
Peace be with you all. And I hope you have a great time, and whatever you're doing, do it well. Yay!
Peace of the Lord.
And who's your friend?
Eva says, peace of the Lord, too.
They say cleanliness is next to godliness. These will give you 99.9%. The peace of the Lord will give you 100%.
Hi, guys. I'm here in my garden to show off my deer. That's his name, too, deer. He's the keeper of my wind chime collection. And my wildflowers, which unfortunately are probably going to be gone with Tuesday's snow. But we're all here to wish you the peace of the Lord. May it always be with you.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Wally. Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance. Govern them and lift them up forever. Day by day we bless you. We praise your name forever. Lord, keep us from all sin today. Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy. Lord, show us your love and mercy, for we put our trust in you. In you, Lord, is our hope, and we shall never hope in vain. O God, because without you we are not able to please you, mercifully grant that your Holy Spirit may in all things direct and rule our hearts through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Wally.
Prayers of the people. Rejoice in the waters of life, those who honor God in all things, and raise your voices in prayer, responding, Lord, hear our prayer. In thanksgiving for this holy day, where we gather as a household of faith to hear the word of God with open minds and grateful hearts, let us pray. Lord, hear our prayer. In thanksgiving for the arms of forgiveness that embrace us in the midst of sin, leading us to repentance and filling us with the waters of mercy through which we will forgive others, let us pray. Lord, hear our prayer for honesty in government and integrity in our dealings with one another, that trust may be restored between people and throughout the institutions of our society. Let us pray. Lord, hear our prayer, that we may commit ourselves to a life of simplicity, so that we may provide for the needs of the poor and hungry, as Jesus provided nourishment and hope to his followers. Let us pray, Lord, hear our prayer, that we may share our spiritual doubts with one another, convinced that in our mutual self-disclosure, we will be strengthened in faith and grow in the conviction that God's love can forgive all things and transform all life. Let us pray. Lord, hear our prayer. In thanksgiving for those who are teachers, may they be given the blessing of knowledge and wisdom as they instruct all those placed in their charge. Let us pray. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for our loved ones who are in need of strength or healing, including Dale, Sandra and Roger, Jenna, Donnie and Lori, Mickey, Jordan and Molly, Matt and Jenny, Kate, Chris, Ed and Tony, Tom and Linda. We pray for those who are homebound, including Donna, Janice, Lenore, Betty, Maggie, Arlene, Hank and Olga, Pat and Leah, and those we name before you now.
Make us one people today, dear Lord. Make us worry only about the whole family. Give us your beauty and generous creativity, that we might be woven together in love. In Christ's holy name we pray. Amen. Let's say together the prayer of St. John Chrysostom. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Wali. For our closing hymn, let's join our choir in singing, Blessed Are the Pure in Heart. Things calm. You are the place to hide from harm. You are the light that shines in the dark. You are the heart's eternal spark. You are the door that's open wide. You are the guest that waits inside. You are the stranger at the door. You are the calling of the poor. Now go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Amen.